გამარჯობა, მე მქვია ნარმინა. Sorry, but this is Georgian Narmina. Hey, я хетер Нармина. And this is Swedish. Салам, менім адам Нармінадыр. This is Azerbaijani. Здравствуйте, меня зовут Нармина. This is Russian, what's wrong with you? Мераба, менім адам Нармина. This is Turkish, you're supposed to talk in English. Okay, my inner voice. I just wanted to flash around my language skills. Hello! As you have seen, I'm Нармина. I'm from Georgia. No, not from the States, but from the Caucasus. Next to Russia, Turkey, Azerbaijan, Armenia and the Black Sea. After studying in Georgia, Ireland and Austria, I decided to study in Sweden as well. Although it's physically so far and in the north, I still wanted to become a part of its everyday life and educational system. But there are really rational reasons why I chose Sweden. First of all, the idea of human and human being and human rights and everything related to human is so appreciated, valued and protected in Sweden. This is well expressed in the way they protect personal information and in the gender equality. The second reason is related to the protection of everything beyond human, the way people in Sweden contribute to sustainable development. A great example for this is the eco-village in Gotland, where the idea of sustainable development is highly promoted. Healthy lifestyle and diet is one of the priorities in Sweden. I also try my best to avoid junk food such as sugar. The first two reasons lead us to the third reason, which is the culture of recycling and secondhand. I'm also concerned about the resources we have. I also try to promote and contribute to the recycling culture in Georgia, which is not that much popular. I try to separate paper and give it to a special recycling company. The next reason is lagom. I'm not sure about the pronunciation of the word, but it is something I myself want to learn and use in my life. I think that life is all about finding balance in everything, in career, friendship, romantic relationships, family, eating, traveling, studying, and you need to find balance between these everything to make your life easier and happier. And lagom, which is Swedish secret to happiness, meaning not too much and not too little, sounds and looks really fascinating and something that everybody needs to learn. Fika is an interesting tradition and example for lagom, during which people gather for a while to have a coffee and socialize with each other. This also shows how they try to have a rest in the middle of work. And last but not least, I think that the education system at the universities in Sweden is of a high quality, offering wide range of courses, inclusive environment oriented to improvement and development.